Let's talk about a systems programming approach to MLOps. One of the things I hear a lot is a production first mindset. And I think it's a really great way to think about machine learning operations. In my opinion, it's a systems programming problem. First, let's define what systems programming is. If you look at Linux, for example, that's the classic, you know, systems programming problem where if you close a laptop, it'll automatically put your operating system to sleep. And if you open it up, it'll resume, right? These kind of low level energy management type systems where performance is critical. Likewise, with machine learning operations, performance is critical. If you think about it, what we're doing when we're training machine learning models is we're taking giant data sets and giant computational farms and trying to squeeze as much as we can out of it. If you can't afford to spend 75 times more than your competitor, there's going to be a real problem if you're using a bad approach. And that's really where a language like Rust, a modern language, comes into play. And so let's talk a little bit about this concept of Rust versus Python in a systems approach. And I think first what I'll start off with is talk about The Innovator's Dilemma. So this is a classic book from Clayton Christensen where he talks about how there's a paradox where at the very beginning, if you're the most innovative company, because you're listening to your customers, you're unaware of the emerging competitor with a disruptive technology. And so if we look at Python, it's a wild success. So if you look at Python, it's a wild success, right? No one can critique that Python hasn't been successful. It's the number one programming language in terms of adoption. But just like with the Innovator's Dilemma, we can see some new disruptive technologies taking place. And in particular, this sports fan type mindset of we're number one, I think isn't the right approach when you're thinking about trying to find the best solution for the problem at hand. In particular with Python, what is it amazing at? API documentation, right? You can't beat it. In terms of readability, yeah, really, you can't beat it. In terms of just really quickly doing some non-computationally expensive operation, like, you know, reading some stuff from a file and, you know, changing text and rewriting the file, like it's really an ideal solution. But when we talk about the systems programming problem, I just discussed this with Rust, it's critical that we have high performance, and it's critical that we have high performance inference as well. And one of the things that you may be asked to do if you're doing machine learning operations is to take, let's say, a Hugging Face pre-trained model, package it together with a command line tool, and then build a high performance binary that is able to traverse millions and millions of documents and summarize those documents with the lowest cost possible. That isn't an optimal solution for Python. Python isn't a language that's designed to do, you know, efficient multi-threaded programming. So I think that's really one of the things to be very careful about, is to look at what's important when you're dealing with the problem at hand. And so if we take a look at Python versus Rust, you know, let's first start off with, you know, the energy efficiency. So Python uses the most energy of any language, you know, in relative terms, you know, plus or minus a couple rankings. Rust uses the least energy of any language, right, in recent research. What about binary deploy? Python doesn't have the concept of binary deploy. It's not something that it was designed to do. Rust has binary deploy by default. Likewise, Python has batteries included for the standard library, but it doesn't have batteries included packaging. There's many competing solutions from the Python packaging tools like virtual environment and pip and conda and poetry and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Rust, there's one solution. The packaging is included. Also, Python is one of the slowest languages in terms of computational speed. Recent research has shown, you know, up to 70 times slower than Rust. Rust is one of the most efficient in terms of performance languages that exists. And the other thing is software engineering productivity tools are not included with Python. So the Python interpreter is obviously super performant in terms of trying out ideas, but it doesn't have a built-in formatter. It doesn't have a built-in linter. It doesn't have a built-in compiler. These tools do, though, come with Rust. Rust includes all of these software performance productivity tools with the default installation. In terms of threads, one of the things that Python has done is it's an amazing language, but it made some compromises 30 years ago. And one of the things that it compromised was to lock, because at the time, maybe compiler technology wasn't as sophisticated as it is today. And you cannot use multi-threaded programming that uses all the cores. And now we have, you know, 100 core plus machines. And that really is an issue. With Rust, it's trivial. And in fact, the compiler helps you create safe multi-threaded code. So if you do need to do high-performance multi-threaded programming, Rust is the solution that you should use. And also, it's very memory efficient. In many scenarios, it's at least 2 times better at memory efficiency than Python, but in many cases, even more if you use multiprocessing. Also, the language safety in terms of Python is a bolt-on. So it isn't the case that all of a sudden with Python, you get, you know, safe typing and compiler and all those kinds of things. You can do some of those things, but actually you have to bolt those on, right? You have to install some secondary package, or the language itself wasn't designed to have strong typing. And you can put those things on, but it's not designed for it. Rust is designed. The original design of the language was for safety. It has an amazing typing system. It has an amazing way of preventing memory leaks. That's really the design of the language. Also, Python, again, it's a victim of its own success. Wildly, wildly successful, just like Clayton Christensen prophesized, was that the leader, because it's responding to customers, and I think the classic thing I hear a lot of people say is that, you know, developer time is better spent than computational time. That may have been the case before multi-core machines, before MLOps, but it is not the case today. In fact, sustainability is important, and Rust is designed as a modern language to be sustainable. Also, a great example of systems programming is, if it's in Linux, it's probably a systems programming approach. Python is not used to develop the Linux kernel. Rust is. All right, so those are some of the main takeaways. Doesn't mean that Python's a bad language. It's an amazing language. Doesn't mean that Python's not an awesome success story. It is an awesome success story, but what was successful in the past doesn't predict what is always successful in the future. And I believe Rust is the correct language for MLOps.